Hello everyone, I'm Jacob Czakarewski and I'll present our work entitled Wi-Fi VLC Dual Connectivity Streaming System for 6 Degrees of Freedom Multi-User Virtual Reality. This is a joint work with Mahmoud Urkan and we gratefully acknowledge the support of our sponsors. Here's a brief illustration of our system. It comprises a net server that streams 6 DAW VR content to mobile VR users over two wireless technologies, VLC, Visible Light Communication, and Wi-Fi. Our contributions are, we explore edge adaptation of the present omnidirectional viewpoint of a user via scalable tiling, developing a panoramic baseline content layer and a viewport-specific enhancement content layer. We then synergistically stream these two layers over Wi-Fi VLC, dual connectivity streaming, and we carry out formal pre-distortion analysis optimization of the server's action, leading into a low complexity solution enabled by the use of scalable tiling. We also explore dynamic VLC transmitter steering and assignment via graph bottleneck matching, formulating a lower complexity polynomial time solution. We also contribute the first public 6 degrees of freedom VR navigation dataset. And finally, we demonstrate strong viewport quality and application reliability gains for traditional state-of-the-art and Li-Fi, that is VLC-only approaches. The motivation for our work is that virtual reality is an emerging technology that has potential for broad societal impact. However, presently it is limited to gaming, entertainment, cable operation, and low fidelity graphics. And that is because this application requires very challenging characteristics, such as ultra high data rate and ultra low latency, that cannot be met by present and upcoming traditional networks. Moreover, existing 360 degree video practices are quite underperforming as they use traditional video approaches in the operation. Moreover, in the mobile wireless settings, the experience is even more poor due to the even more limited resources in such environments. However, untethered high fidelity VR applications can have the highest societal impact, advancing quality of life, the global economy, energy conservation, and at present, make an impact on the COVID pandemic as well. We leverage a few new technologies in our work, and the first one is VLC, that is characterized by very high data rate of transmission and very low delay, therefore. However, the downside is that the VLC links are very narrow and directed, and therefore they can be fragile. So we need to take care of it, need to address that. Moreover, we use an edge server because it helps bring the required data and computing closest to the users. And finally, we leverage a scalable 360-degree tiling that can facilitate viewport adaptation and exploring ray distortion trade-offs. Though there has been several studies exploring tiling-based viewport adaptive streaming for efficient utilization of network resources, they're still bounded by the fundamental limitations of the traditional wireless technologies and server client architecture they use. However, MPEG expects that for good quality, next generation high quality immersion, the content needs to comprise 12K spatial resolution and 120 frames per second frame rate that is certainly not feasible to be supported by what exists today. And in our work, we leverage our previous design of a VLC-enabled headset. Here's an outline of the rest of our talk. We first present briefly our system architecture models. We then present how we plan to maximize the deliverable quality across the users. We carry out experimental analysis via simulations, and finally we conclude. Our arena is divided into cells, and is a ceiling-mounted LED transmitter for each cell. The server is linked using fiber optics to the LEDs and the Wi-Fi access point. There are also infrared base stations that track the user's 6 degrees of freedom coordinates, meaning the spatial location and the head orientation. The baseline and enhancement content layer that are constructed are streamed to a parallel Wi-Fi VLC links, and the users wear dual connectivity headsets that we explore. We formulate the 6 degrees of freedom navigation as a, as a collection of spatial 360-degree viewpoints that the users can select to explore or browse. And we use scalable 360-degree tiling to represent each such viewpoint in multiple signals layers, as illustrated here, where we compress each GOP tile into multiple embedded layers of increasing fidelity, and then the baseline enhancement VR content that is streamed to the user is comprised by combining tiling layers. We also benefit from our earlier work that provides formal characterization of the delivered viewport quality based on the assigned downlink data rates to Wi-Fi and VLC to stream the two content layers. Now, because VLC links can be fragile, due to the very narrow beam that they comprise, they can lead to transient loss, and therefore we synergistically integrate them with Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi provides application reliability, as explained in the paper, and VLC provides the desired high-quality immersion. The VR headsets feature dual Wi-Fi VLC receivers, where the VLC receiver comprises a hemispherical design of multiple photodiode layers for robust link, meaning no matter what the user's head orientation may be, at least several of these photodiodes will be able to basically connect with the optical link. And we optimize the design based on an angle diversity approach. Now, our aim is to maximize delivery pure quality across all users, such that the assigned data rates to all users across Wi-Fi do not exceed the capacity of the Wi-Fi link. And similarly, the assigned data rates to every user served by an LED transmitter do not exceed the capacity of the VLC transmitter. Now, if you consider, for fairness, that the Wi-Fi and the VLC resources of an LED are uniformly shared across the users that are served, this will lead to a parallel convex optimization across every user transmitter pair. Moreover, given that the content is scalable and the objective function DU is monotonic, we can provide an even more effective formulation that in the end we can solve at very low complexity due to the use of scalable tiling. In fact, we can solve the problem of rate allocation and construct the baseline enhancement content layer simultaneously. And the solution basically comprises finding the first LB layers of a scalable tiling that do not exceed the capacity of the Wi-Fi link associated to user U. And similarly, then we need to find the subset LE layers only for the viewport tiles of that user that do not exceed the capacity of the VLC link assigned to the user. Now, to account for user mobility and maintain and optimize the fragile VLC connectivity, we consider that the transmitters are mounted on a mechanically steerable platform so that they can be directed toward the user. And there are two servo motors that control the vertical and horizontal rotations of the transmitter. And they facilitate the user tracking information to pinpoint towards the user. Moreover, as a user moves away from a transmitter, we also carry out periodic transmitter assignment during a session for maximum performance. Here's an illustration of how the transmitter assignment steering works. Initially, each user is assigned to the transmitter in the cell in which the user resides, shown by the left illustration. Now, the middle illustration shows that when a user moves from cell A to cell C, then the transmitter, originally assigned transmitter will follow it to the next cell. And moreover, the right-hand illustration shows that it can happen that multiple users may be presently located in a cell, in which case they will be creating interference with each other with their respective beams. And so in this context, we are interested to assign every user to the transmitter that leads to the maximum signals to noise ratio for the user. And so we carry out, we formulate a min-max problem where, because the SNR is, sorry, we carry out a max-min problem that can be reformulated into a min-max problem because the SNR is inversely proportional to the distance of a user from a transmitter. And so we want to minimize the maximum distance from every user to assigned transmitter. Now, this problem is of combinatorial complexity and it's NP-complete, and therefore we pursue in the paper a lower complexity graph theoretic method where we place the users in one set and place the transmitters in another set, and we construct a weighted bipartite graph of all possible connections between users and transmitters, where the weights basically comprise the distances between the users and the transmitters. And assigning a user to a transmitter then can be studied as a bottleneck graph bottleneck matching on this graph G, where we basically use for the maximum size vertex matching between users and transmitters whose largest edge weight is as small as possible. Okay? And we can show that we can carry out an efficient algorithmic solution for this problem using a Dalmich-Mendelson decomposition. This is a graph theoretic approach. Finally, to briefly explain our VLC channel modeling, the lighting of a VLC transmitter is formulated as a Lambertian radiation pattern. This is a very standard approach. And then we can use maximal ratio combining to integrate the received VLC signals from every photodiode at the headset using the expression shown below, which is used to compute the received SNR from transmitter T. We refer to the paper for more details. Finally, for our simulation evaluation, to collect the navigation data, we design a 6 by 6 meters by 4 meters arena, which we then split into 6 cells. We use the SteamVR software to stream the data from a content server to an HTC Vive wireless headset worn by a user, as shown in the left picture or illustration, and use OpenTrack software to collect these navigation samples, where we provide 30,000 tracking samples for a trace at 250 samples per second. The content is Virtual Museum and there are 18 users, and the right hand side illustration shows a sample navigation pattern for a user across the arena. The VLC transmitter have a transmission have a beam width or a divergence angle of 25 degrees. The VR headsets have 47 photodiodes, and the field of view is 1.5 theta D. As described before, using scalable tiling, we represent each spatial 360-degree viewpoint that a user can select into 12K spatial resolution and 120 frames per second. And we measure the delivered viewport quality via PSNR for every user. Now we compare the two state-of-the-art reference method, LiFi, which is a cellular-based VLC system, and Dash, which uses the streaming standard to send the data over Wi-Fi. If you observe this graph that shows the temporal viewport quality of our system and compare to LiFi, we can see that there are some instances where there is transient loss of the VLC link, and that impacts the LiFi system so that it basically leads to application downtime. However, in our approach, our system can then switch to deliver only the baseline representation using Wi-Fi, and therefore there is no application downtime in our case. And so if you compare our approach to Li-Fi as well as to an instance of our system where no Wi-Fi is available to be used, we can see that we observe 5 dBs and 7 dBs viewport quality gains, respective to no Wi-Fi case for our system and Li-Fi. And moreover, we observe a 3 times smaller viewport quality variation for our system compared to these two other methods. Moreover, we observe 0 application downtime for our system, which is shown by this third small graph in the inset, compared to 22% application downtime for the proposed system with no Wi-Fi and Li-Fi. Similarly, if you observe the distribution of viewport quality across the users, we can see that our system provides a consistently high viewport quality across all users, slightly more than 50 dBs PSNR and 3 times smaller standard deviation. Moreover, if you observe that this horizontal dashed line by that shows the performance of Dash, we can see that, like as illustrated, discussed before, traditional approaches such as Dash can not provide really good quality in this context to deliver 12K 120 frames per second to VR content. Dash has only 39 dBs of viewport quality. And finally, as the number of users increases in the system, both our system as well as LiFi will experience degradation in quality, which is expected. In LiFi, there will be more instances where multiple users are residing in the same cell, and therefore the resources of a single LED transmitter will have to be split across them. Similarly, in our case, there will be more instances where multiple users are co-located in the same cell, and therefore their beams that track them will interfere with each other. However, in our case, we observe that we have higher robustness to user load, where we observe that we have still maintained consistent 6 to 7 dB viewport quality gains over LiFi, and we provide more graceful performance degradation. So in conclusion, we explore the future Wi-Fi VLC dual path 6 degrees of freedom multi-user VR streaming system that provides reliable high fidelity immersion. The system comprises edge adaptation of the present 360 degree viewpoint of a user via scalable tiling. It also comprises synergistic Wi-Fi VLC dual connectivity streaming of the two content layers. We carry out firmware and distortion analysis optimization of the edge server's access. And we also explore dynamic VLC transmitter steering and assignment by graph bottleneck matching for multi-lower complexity polynomial solution relative to the original combinatorial min-max approach, which is exponential complexity. We also contribute the first public 6 degrees of freedom VR navigation dataset, and we demonstrate strong viewport quality and application reliability gains for traditional state-of-the-art and LiFi-only approaches. With that, I conclude the presentation and leave the floor open for questions. Thank you.